Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event here tonight.
Look it out here.
Andre.
The Giant.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a price.
Rest.
My God, what a
night. Hey, this is
the man. Give it hell now.
It's not over.
The world is watching.
Starting things off with some action from Monday Night Raw, I'm Michael Cole alongside the Hall of Famer, Jerry the King Lawler.
You know, I am so excited about this match. And I know you get to be there on the NXT and see these young superstars develop. What do you think about Michael Tarver?
I haven't been impressed with Michael Tarver.
I'll
tell you why. He's only won one match, number one. He's near the bottom of the pros poll, number two. And number three, for some reason, he continues not to participate in the rookie challenges each and every week, despite the fact that he at least tried this past Tuesday night.
Well, no sugarcoat it. Other than that, what you really feel about the guy.
He seems to have all the potential. And here is Primo set to take on his brother Carlito here on WWE Superstars. Remember these two men? Last year had a falling out after they lost the Unified Tag Team Championship. First ever Unified Tag Team Champion, so should be an exciting match here tonight.
I'll never forget when I had a falling out with my big brother.
What happened?
Well, a few of my teeth fell out.
So here we go with action. The 218-pounder Primo against his 220-pound brother Carlito as Michael Tarver looks on. Tarver's had his problems here on Superstars over the past few weeks, costing Carlito a couple of matchups with a, well, quote, rookie mistakes.
And maybe that explains the sour look on the face of Carlito and just the all-around bad move.
Hook of the leg and a kick out by Carlito. Something just happened along the way for Carlito. Remember when he burst on the scene here in WWE King, really took World Wrestling Entertainment by storm, won the United States Championship, the Intercontinental title, as I mentioned, the Unified Tag Team titles.
And I wonder if the attitude of Carlito has anything to do with the fact that, well, that Michael Tarver hasn't been more successful than he is. I mean, you know, hey, let's face it, you know, you're probably only as good as the guy that's mentoring you.
It could very well be. Tarver's talked about his relationship on WWE. Look at this. Primo looking for the victory and a kick out on WWUniverse.com in his blog. Tarver's talked about his relationship with Carlito. Mostly has some great things to say about it. Says he's been a great tutor.
Whoa,
splendid move by Primo. The high octane, high flyer. Really has Carlito off balance here. And Carlito's been doing a lot of complaining as of late, too, about his treatment by our guest hosts on Monday Night Raw over the past number of weeks.
Well, I don't know if it's so much treatment as it is just basically being overlooked.
Do you think he deserves what he's getting, though? as he goes into the cover, yet again hooks the leg and a kick out.
Well, I think there's obviously certain ways you go about getting what you want. I mean, you know, there's the old adage of the squeaky wheel gets oil first, but I don't, in the case of our guest host on Raw, I don't think that's the right way to go about it. No.
Again, Carlito looks to pick up the win on his brother here in a kick out of two. Highly competitive matchup between the two brothers, sons of the legendary Carlos Colon.
And you can bet your bottom dollar that Carlos is looking on right now down in Puerto Rico. What do you think he thinks of this, seeing his two sons go at each other like this? When at one time they were probably one of the most successful tag teams in the WWE.
And I wonder if he's had any contact with Carlito and if he's offered any advice to Carlito about this situation and perhaps coming up with remedies to get through it.
Maybe we should call Carlos. I have his number.
You do?
I do.
I have everybody's number, though.
You don't have one of those Hall of Famer phone books?
I don't even have your number.
Oh, look at this!
Cross body.
Great
lateral
move.
Press hook of the leg. Two Whoa. Count kick out. And Tarver, I believe, is one of those rookies who is on the bubble on NXT. Could be facing elimination Tuesday night.
Well, Primo may have just gotten his bubble burst there. I mean, he came up after that nice move, turned right around and walked right into the big boot of his brother.
And Carlito's expression changed, almost like he's going into punishment mode.
Whoa! Primo not finished dishing out a little punishment of his own. Look at Primo coming.
He is so quick,
yes.
Primo. Off the leg drop. Hook of the leg, and Carlito gets out at a count of two. Primo, offense is so unique. There's just another example of the many ways that he can attack you.
Talk about the intensity of Tarver. I mean, that certainly you need to be, I think intensity is a good thing. You need to be focused, but sometimes you can let it get the best of you. I think that's been the problem with Tarver. Sometimes I think he tries too hard, tries too much.
On nobody home. And Carlito, you see the look in his eyes measuring his brother, and it could be backstabber time as Carlito looks to put Primo away. Carlito trying to build momentum. This would be a huge victory if he could somehow connect with a backstabber here.
Oh, no, this is not good for Primo. Here it comes.
Carlito, and he...
What is this? Is Carlito having a change of heart here? I mean, he could have delivered a backstabber with ease, and this match would be over.
Is this really what you want? Do you think people really want to see two brothers tear each other apart? You care about these people? Forget about these people, huh? They don't care about you. They don't care about me. We're both great competitors, and we deserve a lot more than what we've been getting. You and I, we were the first unified tag team champions. So go ahead, you go ahead and keep on wasting your career, or you can once again make an impact with me. Think about it, Primo.
Wow.
Look at this. Thing or not.
You know what cool is? Yours.
A lot of fun.
Well, I guess Primo plans on making an impact with Carlito.
High impact, non-stop, adrenaline pumping, heart racing, full bore, nail biting, Pedal to the middle. Anything goes. Full throttle. Action-packed. WWE is over the limit. WWE over the limit.
Chavo Guerrero is a 10-time champion. He comes from the legendary Fighting Guerrero family. It's a very unique lucha libre style coupled with a vicious aggression.
And from Los Angeles, California, weighing 265 pounds, the masterpiece, Chris Masters.
And I know your favorite attribute about Chris Masters is his pectoral dance. Hopefully we'll see that at some point.
There's a lot more to Chris Masters than
there it is.
His jovial side. 6'4", 265 pounds, nicknamed the Masterpiece. And if you look at Chris Masters, you can see why. But inside the ring, there's nothing pretty about the beatings that come from Chris Masters.
And everyone knows about the Master Lock. Chris Masters, when he locks it in, no one escapes. We've seen the damage it can do to some of the biggest superstars that WWE's ever seen. John Cena, HBK, the list goes on and on.
A testament to the Master Lock is that it was once called the Full Nelson, utilized by superstars such as Hercules Hernandez and Billy Jack Haynes, but no one does it the way Chris Masters does it. Therefore, the Full Nelson is now the Master Lock.
Chavo Guerrero apparently not too impressed with the Masterpiece's flawless physique. And what a debut it was for Chavo this past Friday night on SmackDown as Kane came to personally welcome him to Friday nights. Oh, here we go. Masters trying to lock in the Master Lock right here, right now. But Chavo wisely grabbing that top rope.
Had Chris been able to clasp his fingers together, we could have seen a very early submission.
Come on, Chavo. Come on.
Chavo Guerrero very excited to be back on Friday Night SmackDown. Told us last week with two Guerreros, imagine the possibilities. Of course, referring to Vicky Guerrero.
Oh, Chris Masters is totally outsmarted Chavo.
Chavo's trying to avoid a physical confrontation at all costs, and it hasn't worked.
The grandson of Gory Guerrero, the nephew of Hector Mondo, and of course, Hall of Famer Eddie Guerrero, Chavo Guerrero, will look to take any advantage.
Wow. How about that for strength and power? Chavo tossed back in the ring like a sack of potatoes.
Oh, there you go.
Standing drop kick from Chavo Guerrero. Perhaps this was part of the master plan all along.
Let's not forget that Chavo brings a style that was made popular by the likes of Tiger Mask and the Dynamite Kid, but Chavo brings the style into the 21st century. And look at Chavo's ability to tag Chris Masters right on the jaw, and now Chavo Guerrero takes over, and you have to say his last name like that.
Really?
Yes.
What if I just call him Chavo? Chavo has honed his craft all over the world, from Japan to Mexico, and now here the pinnacle of sports entertainment, WWE.
Now notice how Chavo will stay in front of his much larger opponent, constantly on the attack.
Chavo can do it as a mat wrestler, chain wrestling, can do anything pretty much. We've seen over the years Chavo has beaten much bigger and stronger opponents before.
This is an interesting submission hold here. Chavo now going to the leg, constantly switching gears. That is a third generation superstar in Chavo Guerrero.
A cover, the shoulders were down there by Chris Masters, who needs to be careful. This, by the way, is the first match Chris Masters has had as part of the SmackDown roster. Masters coming over from Raw as part of the supplemental draft as well.
Look at the great grappling ability of Chavo, riding his opponent, keeping the submission hold locked in, and using all of his body weight.
Textbook performance thus far by Chavo Guerrero.
Think of all the great masterpieces throughout history. Of course, the Mona Lisa, even the Declaration of Independence. A lot of people have forgotten about that, but that's a masterpiece.
Masters finally with a reprieve here, gasping for air. Can Chavo continue the offensive assault? No.
This is exactly what Chavo needs to stay away from, the power of Chris Masters.
You don't want to trade punches and clotheslines with the masterpiece.
Ooh, Chavo looks like he landed right on his left kneecap.
Vicious sidewalk slam from the masterpiece and a kick out at two by Chavo Guerrero.
Notice how Masters comboed those moves together. First the sidewalk slam, into the carry, into the cover, seamless.
Will we see it here on WWE Superstars? Chris Masters trying to lock in the master lock. Chavo knows what's coming.
Notice how Chavo keeps the arm, trying to turn it into an offensive maneuver.
And there it was. What a brilliant counter from Chavo Guerrero. Great counter by the Mexican Warrior.
Now this is where Chavito cannot let his frustrations get a hold of him here. Close the distance, Chavo.
And now the braggadocious flare coming out from Guerrero. Guerrero thinking three amigos.
Whoa.
But no, quickly, the master lock. It's cinched in, it's locked in. And Chavo Guerrero has nowhere to go.
Chavo needs to get to the ropes. Chavo's fading. Notice how his chin is pressed against his chest. Chavo has given up.
Showing you just how lethal the master lock can be.
Well, the beauty of the master lock is that it can come from out of nowhere at any time. Congratulations, Chris Masters.
Flawless.
I know, and our haters make us famous.
I'm flawless.
Ew, what is that smell?
I don't know, but it smells like garbage and rotten eggs.
Yuck.
Ugh. Speaking of garbage, Kelly, Kelly.
Or Smelly Kelly.
That was a good one.
I'm actually, I think that's the smell of a winner from when me and Beth beat you last week.
Oh, beginner's luck.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Ladies, please tell me that both of you shower today.
Ah, so of course we're flawless. It's
P.
You.
Look, I am the queen of problem solving, and since I am the official consultant of SmackDown, I can take care of this.
Official cougar. Yeah. Such a
good idea. Oh, come on,
get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get
her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her
on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on,
get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get her on, get
embarrassing initiation for Kelly Kelly, but as the women's champion, Beth Phoenix chases off the Mean Girls tonight. Beth goes one-on-one with SmackDown's newest diva, Rosa Mendez, and that's coming up next on Superstars.
Hi, this is WWE Diva Eve Torres with an important message for the entire WWE Universe. WWE superstars are professionally trained performers. The moves we do in the ring take years of practice to perfect and to do safely. I urge the entire WWE Universe to never try to copy what we do in the ring, at home or at school. Stay safe. Don't try this.
John Morrison is now on Raw.
I am John Morrison.
A unique style.
The guru of greatness.
The shaman of sexy.
The honcho of hotness.
What's Morrison gonna do here?
Starship Pain, if you've never seen it before, get ready.
You will miss something.
Very innovative, very charismatic.
I am John Morrison.
Welcome back as the women's champion, Beth Phoenix, has arrived on the scene.
Beth Phoenix, the brand new women's champion. That happened at Extreme Rules.
Phoenix, you mentioned winning that women's championship at Extreme Rules. She beat Michelle McCool in an extreme makeover match. I know you won't forget that anytime soon.
And from San Jose, Costa Rica, Rosa Mendez.
And another new member to the SmackDown brand, Rosa Mendez, who came over in the supplemental draft. She, along with Kelly Kelly, the two divas on Friday nights.
Oh, Rosa Mendez, the freaking Costa Rican. Of course, Costa Rica and South America, nestled between Nicaragua and Chile. And of course, that passion and that fiery Latina.
Why are you rolling your R's? You're from Long Island, New York.
Long Island, New York, New York. I'm trying to tout the wares of Rosa.
Yo soy Rosa Mendez. And for those of you who are not bilingual, I'll let you know what I'm talking about. My name is Rosa Mendez, and I've just been drafted to SmackDown. Yo soy una campeona. Y tú no vas a ser una campeona para mucho tiempo. Beth Phoenix's days of being a champion are coming to an end. Adios. Glamazon.
I guess Glamazon in Spanish is Glamazon.
Welcome, Rosa Mendez. Muy loco.
Loca, she's female.
I was talking about you.
Thanks. Look at the look on Beth Phoenix's face.
Oh! Is that the look you're talking about? Rosa Mendez. Pardon the cliche, has surely bitten off more than she can chew.
Ooh. Oh, yeah. Oh. I have to admire Rosa's ability or attempts to try to make a name for herself, but not at the expense of the women's champion.
She's making a name for herself, all right. Beth Phoenix won't forget Rosa Mendez. Look at these hammering blows from WWE's dominant diva. Matt, I know sometimes it's smart to try and get inside your opponent's head, but is that the way you want to do it?
Again, I don't think that Rosa, you know, foresaw Beth's response. I'm sure this played out a lot differently in Rosa's cabeza. And again, Rosa very clever here, and now the opportunity to take over.
You're right, maybe she was drinking too many cervezas.
I didn't say that, I said cabeza, two different words entirely.
Rosa finally getting some offense in after that early onslaught by Beth Phoenix.
And notice how the referee, the official, is just doing his job, but Rosa is taking advantage of the openings. Schoolgirl!
Nice roll up from Beth Phoenix, who used finesse, not power, to get that win.
Rosa didn't really get a chance to get started, but alas, the fabulous Firebird, Beth Phoenix, looks like she's limping, perhaps a residual effect from one of those kicks to her thigh, but nevertheless, still your women's champion. Congratulations, Beth Phoenix. Take a listen to this. Wham! But Beth Phoenix would later make Rosa Mendez pay.
Well, Beth Phoenix, it appeared that Rosa had done some severe damage to Beth Phoenix's knee, but the women's champion using finesse, as I mentioned, to get the roll up in the win.
We're looking over here, and it was the point of Rosa's toe, the boot to the hamstring. Now, let's not forget, the flat of the foot is legal. The toe is generally frowned upon, depending on the official.
Well, Rosa Mendez made an impact tonight, but Beth Phoenix gets the win, and hopefully we'll have an update on the women's champion before we go off the air.
Well, no more crime time, no more good times, only Shad's time. But will the clock run out? We will find out in a rematch from Extreme Rules. Former Best Friends Collide here on Superstars. Do not adjust your television sets. That is actually two separate people.
I'm Nikki.
I'm Bree. We're the Bella Twins.
Oh, it just got red hot. It's a double dose of smart, sexy, and powerful.
Okay, so Bree is on the right and Nikki on the left?
No.
So Bree is on the left and Nikki is on the right. Backgrounds in gymnastics and soccer.
Oh, there's the switch.
That's twin magic right there. Bellas are two separate beautiful women.
Aw, thank you.
Tonight, for the first time in 3.5 years, the cutting edge is back on Monday Night Raw. The shocking guest, the Viper, Randy Orton.
Like it or not, the most controversial superstar in the history of the WWE is back on Raw. I'm sure all of you want an explanation as to why I did what I did to Randy Orton.
RKO connecting!
I'll go back in history a little bit. I'll go back to when I came back to win the Royal Rumble. I was poised to be the white knight, the shining light on SmackDown. It took me longer than I expected, but I was in the perfect place to beat Jack Swagger and become the new world champion. And last week, I get drafted to Raw. And poof, all of that hard work up in smoke. So I figured I had to start over on a brand new show. And yeah, I may have cost Randy Orton the WWE Championship, but at the end of the night, I was the most talked about superstar on this or any other brand. But I'm getting ahead of myself. I should probably bring out my guest.
Well, our guest host of Monday Night Raw tonight, Wayne Brady.
Expecting Randy Orton.
I came here tonight not to challenge anyone, but to tell any other guest host, all the mini-me's, to Cheech and or Chong, you're not me. This is my house tonight.
That felt really good.
That felt pretty good. Really now good. Look straight in that camera and tell them.
Jacksonville, make some noise.
Jacksonville's making some noise, all right. At the sight of that young man.
Hear me out, Randy, hear me out. Last week was a case of you being in the wrong place at the wrong time. I had to make a statement. You'd have done the same thing and you know it. The last time you were a guest on this show was years ago, but remember what happened? We became rated RKO. And Randy, we dominated. I know that it can happen again. Who can stop us? Does that idea not appeal to you, Randy? You will join me. Are you listening to me?
Is this registering in your head? Say something.
Oh, went for the RKO. Edge! Going for the spin. RKO! In midair! Not quite the night Edge expected on his return to Monday Night Raw, thanks to the Viper.
What a moment on Raw as Randy Orton showing how lethal he can be with yet another RKO, which brings us to this major announcement. I'll let you do it.
Thank you so much. At Over the Limit, we have just learned that it will be Edge versus Randy Orton one-on-one. And on the heels of what transpired this past week on Monday Night Raw, you can only imagine the venom that'll take place in this contest.
How do you get out of the friend zone with a girl you like and into the boyfriend scene?
Ooh, John, you do so with caution.
You need to relax and let it take its course.
Tell her how you feel. I mean, she can't guess. You gotta go from that friend zone to the boyfriend zone very slow. Be smooth and cool about it.
Just stop being buddy-buddy and start being a little bit more romantic.
What do you think is the greatest invention of all time?
Jeff, I'd have to say the greatest invention is spray tan. It keeps me bronze and sexy, but UV free. I have to go with the airplane.
Without a doubt, my BlackBerry.
Text messaging.
I can run my life out of that little piece of equipment.
I mean, I wouldn't be able to do this job if I couldn't fly from city to city, day after day, week after week.
Wanna ask a diva? Visit Ask the Divas at WWEUniverse.com.
Former tag team partners and best friends will collide in the much-anticipated rematch from Extreme Rules. Big Shad Gaspard versus JTG, next, only on Superstars.
Buonasera. My name is Santino Mori.
Former two-time Intercontinental Champion.
And Tino knows how to be a crowd pleaser.
Of course, you have to beware of the Cobra.
Don't let that strike.
I brought my two Roman soldiers, Pasquale and Francesco.
Santino has made quite a reputation.
Well, the expression has changed.
Santino threatening the Cobra, and look at...
I'm gonna teach you a lesson so good, you're going to call me Professor.
Unified tag team titles on the line. The Big Show and Miz defending against the Hart Dynasty. Look at this. Referee's vision obstructed. Sharpshooter! We've got new tag team champions!
Give us someone, anyone, give us some competition.
Yes. And that mouth of his.
Come on! We're the reason these people are here! We're the reason people pay!
Big Show had enough of The Miz and his mouth.
You're on this show. This show's nothing without me. You should have listened to me before. You know, are you listening to me now? Are you listening at all?
Yeah, I heard you.
Big Show.
As much as he talks, a big game wouldn't work out too good for him, if you know what I mean.
You are looking at the only superstar born to be champion.
Well, Jack, I think we've heard just about enough from you, player. Now, the new number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Well, you're many things, Jack Swagger. But you're not like I am. See, I am the world's largest athlete.
Oh! The knockout blow! That's the third knockout! knockout of the night, and no one gets up when the giant man delivers a knockout blow.
Heavy-handed number one contender has been dropping everyone in sight. What will be the case tomorrow night when the Big Show comes to SmackDown?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 230 pounds, JTG.
JTG, once a member of Prime Time along with Shad Gaspard. They were inseparable just over a month ago, Matt. But oh, how things have changed.
Well, it was at Extreme Rules where JTG confronted Shad Gaspard in a strap match. Listen to the physicality from this contest. A leather strap that joins these two, used as a weapon throughout the match. The object is to touch all four corner posts in succession. Shad is doing that, but watch how clever JTG is. Right behind his former partner. And then right as they got to number four, JTG was able to turn it around. There's the shout out, and then the block is hot. JTG finally defeats Shad. And now tonight, Todd, we have the rematch here on Superstars.
A huge win for JTG, no doubt about it. Gaspard looking for redemption here tonight.
And from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 290 pounds, Shad Gaspard.
Well, Gaspard has made it clear it's no longer crime time, it's my time.
It's going to be slow singing and flower bringing if Shad's alarm starts ringing. I've been a big Shad Gaspard fan. I never really kind of invested in JTG. Maybe I'm more of a rock and roll guy. I've never raised the roof. I've never gotten jiggy with anything.
So I know that's true.
I'm into the more thugged out style of Shad Gaspard versus the flashy kind of, Nick Cannon smooth kind of way of JTG.
Well, Shad Gaspard said he was burdened by JTG when they were on Crime Time.
You have to believe the embarrassment from Extreme Rules is weighing heavy on the mind of big Shad Gaspard. Here we go.
Let's face it, JTG outsmarted Shad Gaspard at Extreme Rules.
Just said embarrassing.
Well, he didn't say outsmart.
Okay.
JTG flying through the air. He's known as Brooklyn's flyest, proving it right now, going for a quick cover. Shad Gaspard and JTG grew up best friends. When they came to WWE, made a huge impact on the tag team scene, but it all went awry just a few weeks ago.
And again, it's Jay's quickness that will try to outmaneuver Shad's obvious strength and height advantage.
And now look at this, JTG flying through the air like Superman. He's got the advantage now. Can JTG seal the deal? We'll find out next.
Heaps are on their feet. Christian has heart. Christian's been around the block a few times, to say the least. Christian looking to pull the kill switch.
Kill switch coming.
Kill switch, there it is.
We're back here on WWE Superstars. You're watching our main event. Former tag team partners JTG and Shad Gaspard going one-on-one, and it quickly turned around. JTG seemed to be in pretty good shape until Gaspard changed everything. Watch out, another big boot from Gaspard.
But man, you see in the dominant position is Shad Gaspard. And while we were away, Shad took advantage of a unique opportunity. Cover here, Todd.
Hooking the leg, Gaspard in a two count.
Dropping JTG across the ring apron and then really turning the momentum of this contest around.
Shad Gaspard can be so menacing. We've seen him ambush JTG on several occasions when, quite frankly, JTG never saw it coming. And now face to face, Gaspard clearly has the upper hand.
This unique submission hold, the pressure on the lower back as well as the chin. I don't think I've ever seen this used as a submission hold. Usually you'll see guys torque their opponent onto their face.
Come on.
Credit Shad Gaspard for constantly evolving.
Gaspar with his new business-like approach. Has the referee asking questions of JTG.
And that question is, do you want to continue? And you have to believe that JTG has the heart and the fire to keep this match going.
JTG trying to power out, and eventually Gaspard releases the hold. Gaspard, 6'7", weighing nearly 300 pounds, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, so you can imagine the impact that clothesline just had. And this may do it for JTG. No.
Notice how Jay sat right up. Usually from being in the ring, when you sit up like that, it means you're starting to lose oxygen, you're starting to get tired. Sense of urgency is increased for JTG.
Well, Chad Gaspard has this new philosophy, Matt. Told us, be like me, don't share the spotlight with anyone. Take what you deserve, take what you want. And that's what Gaspard is trying to do, as he goes right to an abdominal stretch.
Another submission hold, using his height and strength advantage on his smaller opponent.
It's clear Gaspard trying to inflict as much pain as possible right now on JTG.
There's a lot of animosity between these two former best friends and tag team partners.
Chad Gaspard has made it known his goal is to become the world heavyweight champion, that title currently held by Jack Swagger on Friday Night SmackDown.
How about Chad with a handful of the tights right in front of the official? The only reason the official's not calling it, though, is because Chad isn't pulling on the belt.
Are those really tights?
Well, leather pants, chaps, what do you want me to call them?
Gaspard, absolutely no hesitation in getting physical with JTG. It has been a beatdown for the better part of 5 minutes here.
Again, looking to inflict punishment on the torso. Notice Jay's hands were clasped. Oh, Shad gets his ab stretch on again. We could see another submission.
And you can see Gaspard softening up the ribcage with those clubbing blows. Look at the pain flowing through the veins now of JTG.
This might not seem like much, but Shad is pushing down on his opponent's hips. What that does is it extends the ribcage and makes it even more difficult to get out of this submission hold. Oh, beautiful strategy.
Nice toss from JTG, trying to get some sort of momentum going.
And the official knows the animosity between these two opponents, which is why I can only imagine there wasn't a disqualification there. Kudos to the official for letting this match continue.
And look at JTG, a very athletic cover. Going for Chad Gaspard there. Oh, what a big boot. We've just been informed that Beth Phoenix is currently undergoing medical observation right now. We hope to have a better update for you tomorrow night on Friday Night SmackDown. As JTG's starting to roll. Some hustle and flow here on Superstars. Can JTG ramshackle a huge win here tonight? JTG's opportunity to beat his former tag team partner, 2-0. What a physical confrontation we're seeing here in our main event.
Big Shad, very wise to get a reprieve on the outside that usually breaks your opponent's momentum, but JTG is just that good.
Well, Gaspard wants a timeout. I don't think so. Gaspard on wobbly legs right now. But imagine the pain that JTG's in after those, what, one, two, three, maybe four submission holds.
Oh, did you see the counter by JTG?
Gaspard may be out, ladies and gentlemen. Is that what JTG had in mind? The damage is done.
Very nice. twice. JTG went for that finishing maneuver. Shad held on to the top rope. Could we see Shad taking over? STO!
Emphatic.
One, two, three.
Shad right. Gaspard with an impressive win here tonight.
Here is your winner, Shad Gaspard.
Again, the animosity and rivalry between two former best friends and tag team partners has spilled over. Congratulations, Shad Gaspard, your winner here on WWE Superstars.
Well, here's what happened towards the end. Gaspard able to turn it around. JTG was clearly in control, holding on to that top rope.
And it was Jay's momentum that disoriented JTG enough for Shad to hit the STO, standing for Shad taking over. 1, 2, 3, Shad Gaspard is victorious.
Well, Gaspard showing tonight that perhaps it is his time. Thanks for watching WWE Superstars. We'll see you tomorrow night for Friday Night SmackDown.